see, here you can see there's a bar magnet, a coil, a bulb, and a voltmeter is attached to show the induced EMF. Now, when the magnet is stationary and all these things are stationary, there is no voltage in the circuit. EMF is zero. Now, see, we move the north pole of the magnet towards the coil, the flux changes and induced EMF is induced. And you can see, whenever we stop, the bulb stops glowing. So that means EMF lasts as long as the magnetic flux changes. Other thing you can see, now see, we have south pole. When we take the south pole inwards, the direction of induced EMF changes. Okay, now suppose we have two coils. Lesser number of turns means less magnetic field, less magnetic flux, more number of turns means more magnetic flux. See, now when we move the magnet towards the coil having large number of turns, the magnitude of induced EMF is large. Intensity of the bulb glowing is large. Now if we move the same magnet towards the coil having fewer number of turns, you can see the voltmeter reading. The induced EMF is less as well as intensity is less. So this is how we show the presence of, this is how we show Faraday's law. This is what Faraday said. Now we can see this in with the help of field lines. Say this is the field near the bar magnet. So see, when we are moving, when we are away, the bulb is glowing, but that is a very light glow. As the more the number of lines crossing, more is the magnetic flux, more is the induced EMF, more is the intensity of glow of bulb. Maximum field, maximum intensity of the bulb. Maximum motion, more is the intensity, more is the field. So this is Faraday's law of electromagnetism.